Hello everyone, myself Sanjay Udge, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to discuss conversion of various flip-flops. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to convert various flip-flops from SR to JK, JK to T, JK to D flip-flops. Outline: JK flip-flops, it's a race around condition. T flip-flop, D flip-flop, question answer, excitation table, conversion of SR to JK flip-flops, and finally references. JK flip-flop: in earlier discussion we would have gone through SR flip-flops, in which when S and R both are equals to 1, this condition is not allowed. When both are equals to 1, the output is uncertain or it is invalid. So this difficulty is overcome in the JK flip-flop. So this is the JK construction of a JK flip-flop logical diagram. At the input stage, you will find two NAND gates having three inputs. The first one, J input, then clock and Q bar. The lower one, NAND gate, will have three inputs again, clock, K and Q. So this is the truth table for the JK flip-flop. So for we'll discuss now various conditions, J equals to 0 and K equals to 0. So at this stage, the output Q will remains as previous, whereas Q bar also will remains as previous. Now let us go to the truth table. So the first two columns, J and K flip-flop. The third column is the previous state, Q before clock pulse applied. The fourth column is Q after clock pulse applied, means it's a next state. We can say it as Q plus 1. And the comment, the last column is the comment. Now let us go to this truth table. When both J and K are equals to 0, the first row, when previous state is 0, the output, the next state will be remains same, that is 0. In the second row, again, when J and K equals to 0, and if previous state Q is equals to 1, Qn plus 1, the next state will be equals to 1. That means for J and K equals to 0, there is no change in the output. Now the second combination of inputs, when J equals to 1, K equals to 1, for Q equals to 0, if the previous stage is Q, the next state will become 1. And here again, J equals to 1, Q equals to 0, and if the previous state is 1, the next state will remain 1. Third combination, when J equals to 0, K equals to 1, if previous state is 0, the next state will be 0. If previous state is 1, the next state, now it is going to change, that will be equals to 0. Okay, so the last combination, when both J and K equals to 1, and if previous state is 0, the output state will change to 1. Please note down, output is changing from 0 to 1, and if the previous state is 1, the output will change to 0. It means that if previous 0, next state will be 1. If previous state is 1, the next state will be 0. It's nothing but toggling of the output of at the arrival of each clock pulse. So in the summary, when the inputs J and K equals to 0, there is no change in the output. If J equals to 1, K equals to 0, Q is equals to J, Q bar equals to K, and if both are equals to 1, the output will toggle between 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. So this is the timing diagram. Again, referring to this truth table, I will take one example. Here, when J equals to 1, Q equals to 0, it is a output Q will be high, that is 1. Now here, if J equals to 1, J equals to 1, Q equals to 1, the output will toggle to 0. Why? Because the earlier it is at one logic one level. The race around condition, this is a toggle condition. When both J and K equals to 1, the output of the flip-flop will oscillate back and forth between 0 and 1. So at the end of the clock pulse, the value of Q is uncertain. So this is a T flip-flop. The T flip-flop is obtained by shorting the two inputs J and K equals to 1. So this is basically a JK flip-flop. Here, this is J and K are shorted. So we'll have only one single input as T. So the truth table for this will have either 0 or 1. So in T flip-flop, if the input T is equals to 0, output is 0. If input T is equals to 1, it's a race around condition, the output will be toggle. So this is the truth table for the T flip-flop. T equals to 0, output is 0. If T equals to 1, previous state is 0, now next state will change to 1. If the previous state is 1, next state will be 0. It's nothing but the toggling. That's why the name given T flip-flop. This is a D flip-flop called as delay flip-flop. It is obtained by complementing the J input to the K input of the basic JK flip-flop. So this is the diagram. It's a basically a JK flip-flop. This D flip-flop is obtained by taking a complement of J input and giving it as a K input. So in this case, we'll have only two input combinations as 0, 1 and 1, 0. If D is equals to 0, output will be 0. If D is equals to 1, output will be 0, which is shown by this truth table. Exercise assignment, what is the difference between T and D flip-flop? In T flip-flop, J and K inputs are shorted, hence the input is either 0 or it is 1, and hence the output is either 0 or toggle between 0 and 1. In D flip-flop, the K input is the complement of the J input, the output is equals to J input. It means if J is equal to 0, output is 0, if J is equal to 1, output is 1. This is the excitation table. It's a very important part of the flip-flop conversion. In electronic design, an excitation table shows the minimum inputs that are necessary to generate a particular next state. When the current state is known, they are similar to the truth table and the state table, but they rearrange the data so that the current state and the next state are next state to each other on the left hand side of the table, and the inputs needed to make that state change happen are shown on the right side of the table. So this is the excitation table for SR flip-flop. So the first column present state, second column Q T plus 1 next state. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So these are the output state, present state, next state. And from this we have to determine the what should be the inputs of the SR flip-flop. For 0, 0 output, 0 to 0 output, we must have 0 and X. X is the don't care condition. So it means that for if the present state is 0 and if we want next state to be 0, the input combination SR will be 0, 0 and 0, 1. So in similar manner, these are the different input combinations for the different outputs expected. This one is SR, this one is T, JK and T flip-flop. Conversion of flip-flop. Conversion of one type to another can be done by using a combination logic circuit. For instance, if a JK flip-flop is necessary, the inputs are given to the combination circuit and the output of the combination circuit is given to the input of the actual flip-flop. Therefore, the output of the actual flip-flop is the output of the required flip-flop. We need to combine the excitation table of both flip-flops and make a truth table of flip-flop data input and Q as the inputs of the inputs and inputs of given flip-flop as the output. Then follow the conventional method of logic design. It means conventional logic design means we have to determine using a K-map, we have to find out the Boolean relation between the input and the output. So this is what a conversion of flip-flop using a logical diagram. So this is the given flip-flop. For example, this is suppose we want to go for SR to JK flip-flop. So SR flip-flop will come over here, and this is the combination flip-flop, a required flip-flop. So the required flip-flop is JK flip-flop. So the inputs will be treated over here are J and K. And this is the given flip-flop SR. So this is input S and this is input R. So if you look at this carefully, the inputs combination circuit will have the input, external input, as well as the inputs from the given flip-flop. This is the conversion of SR to JK flip-flop. Okay, so this is the conversion table that makes use of the excitation table and the truth table. On the left hand side you will find the JK flip-flop table, and the right hand side SR flip-flop, because SR is the actual flip-flop we are using, and from this using SR flip-flop we are deriving a JK flip-flop. So make a note of this. JK flip-flop you will find, which is required flip-flop, you will find at the left hand side, whereas SR flip-flop is a truth table, your excitation table you will find on the right hand side. So JK flip-flop 00, we want for this input condition, we want the output to change from 0 to 0. So what are the inputs? The required inputs will be 0x, that is 0110. Similarly, again for JK equals to 0, if the present state is 1, if I want next state to be 1, what is the SR input? It is x0. So again, the third and the fourth column, JK inputs are 0101. I want our present and next state at 00, then 10. What are the inputs? 0x and 01. Again, the last two rows, 11 and 11. So SR next states will be 0110. What are the expected inputs? SR 10 and 01. So this is KMAP gives the regular conventional method to find out the S input. This KMAP consists of J01 and KQN. Here also, so with this conventional method, we got the S is equal to J bar QN, whereas R is equals to KQP. So this is a conventional method we are using. For these are the references, okay, for the conversion for the various flip-flops. Thank you.